With Talk. I'm Philippe Dulle.
I'm Jean Maratta.
And we are part of the Capella development team. And for the one who are wondering what is Squaring the Circle, the Capella Circle, and join us anyway, well, thanks for coming. And the main idea is to show you how we have matched a strict quality process like we have in industrial companies and with the open source environment, communities and partners. And we are doing it with an agile approach. Just before going to this subject, first, welcome to Toulouse. Toulouse is well known for being the space, the city of the space and aerospatial. And if you have time after the conference to visit around and go to the observatory, you will have a great view of the space, especially with this summer day. You might have the chance to see some stars like Polaris, Sirius, among others not well known, like Capella and so on. But if we stay focused on the EclipseCon, you will meet the same name, Sirius, Capella, but in a context slightly different. I will let Jean explain us what is Capella.
What is a model-based system engineering tool? As a software developer architect, you are probably more familiar with software methodologies or languages like UML, for instance. And maybe you are already a user of modeling tools like UML Designer or PyPyRes. In fact, as a system engineer or system architect, the needs are very similar. But in order to achieve a different goal, in order to build a system. The systems that we are talking about can be planes, satellites, radars, and so on. And these complex systems are composed of a set of subsystems that are all interconnected. These systems are often life critical. And in such a context, the need for a modeling tool allowing to maintain the global consistency of the entire system is really important. Capella is such a tool. It is based on a methodology named Arcadia, already well known by a lot of Thales engineers. And this modeling activity can occur at several stages of the system building. And Arcadia allows to share a unified language. For instance, customers can use it to formalize their operational concerns. System architects or engineers can use it to design their architectures and evaluate these architectures in collaboration with the safety experts, for example. IVV guys can use it to formalize their test campaigns. And well, this tool is open source, free. And here is what it looks like. Well, it looks like a typical modeler, right? Currently, Capella is mainly developed by Thales. Thales is, as you may know, is a huge company, around 70,000 employees, and have a huge system engineers population, around 5,000. Capella is actually used by more than 1,000 system engineers within Thales. Of course, not daily by all of them, but according to their modeling activities. This modeling tool, Capella, is delivered within a Thales workbench that manages a lot of different artifacts as requirements, generated documents that can be contractual, test campaigns, etc. And it provides also tools allowing to manage traceability between these artifacts. Capella is released 2 times per year, and the support of the tool is ensured by the development team itself. And we have to deal with several maintenance branches that eventually means several patch releases per year. I talked about the support. The support of the tool is quite important effort for the development team. As if the quality of the tool is appreciated by the Thales system engineers, they even more appreciate how the development team manages the support. and its reactivity, of course. A lot of the Capella users in Thales work in an operational context, and support reactivity is essential for them. So now I will present you Capella more from a technical point of view. Well, it's a modeling tool, it's an RCP platform upon a set of open source technologies like Sirius, KitAlpha, EGF, EMF DiffMerge, and of course the Eclipse platform itself and all the tools around the EMF modeling community. Above this stack, we have a set of tools or viewpoints that are also available. Not always on open source, but they exist. They allow to address specific domains like safety, for instance, or real-time or IVV. Or specific needs like collaborative modeling or product line engineering. And Thales has contributed a lot of this technical stack, as you will see in the next slide on this roadmap. Starting with the EGF and DiffMerge projects in 2012. And then 2013, Sirius was contributed. And finally, in 2015, Capella was contributed first and quickly followed by Capella. Both Capella and KitAlpha are hosted now within Polarsys Eclipse Working Group.
So from a technical point of view, going to open source has been a great challenge. Indeed, it leads to major infrastructure changes for us since we changed our continuous integration server, source control management, and system bug trackers. In 2012, we have contributed EGF and DiffMerge, and some technical stuff allowing to generate code and compare it model. It mainly helped us to understand the open source processes like release IP, the rebranding needs, and Eclipse release trend, and so on. Sirius, the core of diagram layers that you may have heard in previous talk yesterday, was initially developed for Capella and for Thales, developed and hosted by OBO. In 2013, it was contributed as an Eclipse project and is now included in the modeling tool package from Eclipse. It's about 60 plugins that has been rebranded and contributed to the community. In 2015, we have open source Capella, which is around 200 plugins. One of the most impacting infrastructure change were to migrate from IBM ClearQuest and IBM ClearCase for our source control management and bug trackers. And Capella is now hosted in Polarsys, as you can see on the bottom right, but there is some remain hosted in, within Thales, as we will see here. So prior to open source, the global picture was something like that. We see that Sirius and its collaborative capability were hosted in the OBO company, and Capella was hosted within Thales with its SDK companion and collaborative capability. And as we see now, the component has been open sourced. Sirius has moved from OBO to Eclipse Foundation, and the same for Capella. But as you can see in the dark blue, we have kept the legacy product and kept an internal infrastructure to create or build, mainly due to network issues and some Thales specific needs. So the code has been open sourced, but mainly for performance issues, we had to duplicate the integration infrastructure. It was something that we weren't thinking about prior going to open source, but it's something that we need to work on. And as you can see, the complexity has significantly increased compared as before, but it's life. And from a technical point of view, there is, of course, a lot of good points to be in the open source world. First of all, there is a good collaboration with since several years with OBO, which helped us to develop on the open source Sirius. Sirius is now used in several projects other than Capella. And perform the open source transformation has helped us to migrate to more up-to-date development tools and processes like Jira, Git, code review, and sonar analysis. Unfortunately, there is some drawbacks. For instance, since the migration, we have less control on the IT than before, and since Polarsys crew is in Canada, some of them, it leads to delays due to jet lag in case of service disruption. And also, everything cannot be shared in the open source world, like user models, as you may understand. So we have to also maintain internal bug trackers for confidentiality reasons. From a more general view, Capella development team is in the middle of two worlds, the Thales side and the open source world. Indeed, Capella is mainly used and developed by the Thales company, so they are our first users, even though they have to share their model with external partners and subcontractors, and the open source partners have also their own needs. So we are in the middle, but we are trying to link external partnerships needs to be as much possible compliant with the internal operational needs captured. And since there is also a user community in Thales, we answer the link between the both communities, the Thales one and the open source one. Capture needs is done all years long with regular refinement. There is mainly two main channels for this capture. The Thales need captures, which is mainly done through forums, wiki, and the working group, and the external partnerships need captures is done through collaborative project meetings and during coach sessions. We have a democratic process used through several voting sessions in order to select the most valued announcements that we will develop. And we define the roadmap of these main topics during that we will working at the beginning of the year. Since beginning of 2015, Capella development of Capella has moved from a classical waterfall process to agile approach using Scrum process. The duration of the sprint is about 2 weeks with a classical planning meeting, daily stand-up, and the demonstration by the hand. So just to understand the tab that we see below, it's a classical agile wall, but an inverted one. Stories are on the column, whereas they should be in the rows in a classical agile wall. It's mainly due because we have small stories, and it explains why there is many stories that it can't contained in rows. We are trying to apply agile concept, but in a constrained context. For instance, some of our activities are prior to the development, like the operational support within Thales, and it can lead sometimes to sprint disruptions in case of blocking issues. That's the blue column that is prior the stories, and where the blocking issues can appear during the sprint according to our operational users, and it can describe some user stories that we were engaged in the sprint. We are also applying the Thales quality assessment standards, such as providing a set of requirements that should be covered by detailed test plans for any developed enhancements. So it's something that is not open source, but we kept in our Jira. And the system built within Thales have always a long life cycle, meaning for us to maintain several operational branches. Coordination. Coordination is not a quite simple subject to achieve. It's mainly done in two levels. Within the Thales workbench, we have a shared roadmap, and all the development team. And since we have all moved to agile development, we have started this year to use the Scrum process, with meeting with all the product owners, and a shared demonstration between the development teams. The coordination among partners is mainly done with monthly coordination meeting, but sometimes it's something that we have put in place this year is a weekly synchronization with OBO serious development. For external contribution, we have a clear vision of for the external contributions, and to have a clear vision of the roadmap, we are trying to set up a Polaris release train like the Eclipse did, and it's a work in progress.
Well, just a quick overview of all of external partners and contributors. As you can see, there are quite a lot of interested stakeholders. I will not mention all of them, you can read it. Just a few words to mention the main companies that contributed code to the Capella. Of course, OBIO is as a close partner contributed to Capella many times. Intel also contributed within the diffmerge component and its Git integration. Inquiry Labs has also contributed a patch and on diffmerge and also on some querying tools within Thales Capella. And for this subject, I engage you to go to their talk this afternoon that will occur in this same room that will be done by Olivier Constant and Abel Ibidus. Pure Systems also contributed through some developments around their product line engineering tool. And finally, some independent developers that have followed the Capella development for many years and that we really wanted to mention here. Thanks to them. And to sum up some positive and drawbacks feedbacks, first of all, thanks, as I said, to all the ones that have already contributed and the others that are interested users. From the Capella development point of view, using agile method has allowed us to improve the user feedback of our product. It has enhanced our sharing and communication through forum, wikis, and other means that we have already detailed. One drawback is something that we need to work on, is that we have several channels of communications, like wikis, forums, as I said, and they are quite not synchronized for the moment. And as I said, we need to work on it. Another is that unfortunately, we can't fulfill our needs coming from Thales users, but also from external partners. The main reason of that is why we can fulfill them is the lack of resources, as you might guess. So we count on you, and don't hesitate to contribute. You will be welcome. Just a quick overview of how we work. This is the real Capella office. And if you wonder who is who, thanks to them. As Philippe said, don't hesitate to visit Toulouse and especially its observatory. You can also visit us in the central room at the Capella stand. And again, finally, don't hesitate to use Capella or to contribute to it. Thank you. We will have, I think, a lot of time for questions. Thank you. Don't hesitate. Something that we have to rationalize for sure. How we will do that is not quite simple because of, we are working in a closed infrastructure within Thales, and all our users cannot always have access to external resources. So for them, it's complicated to if we put all the information on the PolarSysWiki, for instance, they will not have access to this information. So it's something we have to find a solution that we don't have for the moment.
We're working directly on the open source repositories. Yeah. It's only as a build integration servers that we have duplicated to allow us to build more quickly. But each time a user contributes, there is a build open sources that is triggered. Okay. And then when it is finished, we have also our build that is working on our site.
More concretely, each story will deal to the creation of a Bugzilla, and we will contribute to the typical process, Gerrit, review, okay. Commit, merge, etc.
You are manipulating confidential data, so I'm pretty surprised that you decided to move to open source. So who and why did you decide to do that?
It's mainly to work with partners. As the Thales system engineers have mainly subcontractors and partners, and they want to share the models that they have done for their systems. And the subcontractors need to access to these models done with Capella, and that's why we go to open source to. Because, for instance, Airbus or other big companies doesn't want to have the drawbacks to use a commercial tools from another large company. It's
It was not our decision for sure, but what is important is that Thales consider very important the open source way. Because of, as Philip said, sharing the tool with other partners is really important for subcontracting, but not only. Just to show how we work and how we can collaborate.
There is mainly 80% that is similar between CSML and the Arcadia DSL. There is some bridge, but Arcadia offers also a workflow for our system engineers. And when you use CSML, you run this tool, you don't know which steps to follow at first. And with the Arcadia process, you have a guided workflow for our engineers. And it's mainly to go quickly to something that the user needs or to modelize, and not to understand which profile to use, what kind of meta kinds that you use to on a class. And, I don't know, it's really clear, but.
The process support that is would it be imaginable to have the same process support for standard XML or fundamental?
But they share the same, 80% of the DSL is the same, but some things like instance are not quite yet decided in the CSML standards, and that's something that we have already in the Arcadia DSL. And I see Olivier wants to talk, so.
Switch to?
To Capella directly.
This is the same workbench actually. You are meaning about the slide? This one? The Thales Capella is 99% composed by Capella itself. The 1% is a specific needs to Thales that we can't open source. Yes, it's the same. Yes.
It's the same. It's mainly we add documentation, for instance, the internal how to install Capella in the Thales environment or. Also, and there is some additional need that is proprietary to Thales and not with no interest for input sources. And we have MSI, for instance, we don't install in other zip files, but MSI. So the build is a little different, but it's okay. If you don't have a question, I think we have 10 minutes more for the coffee.
Thank you.
Thank you.